Touch my heart, Lord, speak through me. You can use anything, Lord. You can use me.
God has called us to be His disciples. I am one, and so are you. Good morning, everyone. We, the children of the New Mount Zion Missionary Baptist Church Children's Ministry, are happy that you can worship with us on this, our annual Children's Day service. Our theme for this year is Children Accepting the Call. The children of this ministry not only wants the world know that Jesus Christ is our Redeemer and Savior, but we want them to know that He can be their Redeemer and Savior as well. We will now have invocation by Sister Anna Johnson, which will be followed by our prayer response that will be led by Sister Kiara Cartwright.
Good morning, New Mount Zion. The psalmist said, "Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord." On this Sunday, which is our Children's Day, we truly want to give thanks to God for the children of New Mount Zion. For God said in His words in Psalms 127:3, "Lo, children are an heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is His reward." So we come prayerfully. Lord, we pray for this opportunity to fellowship with one another yet again in our sanctuary and those joining us via Zoom. Father God, we welcome the presence of the Holy Spirit and us pray a special anointing upon this service and our speaker for today. God, we ask your supernatural guidance on our honorees, our children of New Mount Zion. Lord, continue to keep them safely covered under your blood. In the name of Jesus, your Son, we pray. Amen.
I love you. I love you. I love you, Lord, today, because you cared for me in such a special way. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. My heart, my mind, my soul belongs to you. You paid the price for me way back on Calvary. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise.
Thank you so much, Sister Johnson and Sister Kiara. Yes, children are commissioned and called to share the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Let us welcome DeAndrea and Genoa as they encourage us to do just that.
Then Jesus came to them and said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age."
I'm sorry to bother you, Janelle, but what are you reading?
Oh, something I just overheard my parents talking about, the Great Commission. So I decided to read it for myself.
What is it all about, Genoa?
So far, what I've been reading, it's about sharing the good news of Jesus.
Thinking what I'm thinking?
Yes, we can spread the good news of Jesus just like the disciples did.
I think that is a good idea because we know a whole lot of people that could use some good news right about now.
Well, what are you waiting for?
Let's do this!
Thank you so much, Janoa and DeAndrea. Repeat after me, everyone. Let's do this. I just love that action phrase, because when we are doing God's will, we must be bold and courageous. Thank you for sharing with us a short and very powerful skit. Let's do this. Once again, thank you, DeAndrea and Janoa, for sharing and encouraging us. Please join in with Taylor Demerit for our official welcome. Afterwards, we will go straight into our songs of worship.
Good morning, church. The New Mount Zion Children Missionary sent a warm welcome to all those who are worshiping with us on this, our Children's Day. It is our prayer that you equip yourself to share the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Once again, welcome.
Brother Derek Adams, along with Charlie the Yellow Bahamian, who is no stranger to the Bahamas and the children's ministry. Together, they will further share with us about the Great Commission. Mr. Adams will be followed by Kayan Fullerton and Tajay Mackey as they will bless our hearts with a recitation. Please give God a hand clap of praise as they come.
Hello, Charlie.
Hello.
How are you feeling? That's very good. Charlie, we have an interesting topic today. I was walking around the other day, and some people were saying, Only adults supposed to spread the gospel and talk about Jesus. You believe that?
No, sir. No, sir.
Why you don't believe that?
Because Jesus say, make disciples of all nations.
That's right. And what nations consist of?
All the people.
That's right. All the people, including the what?
The adults and the children.
That's right. The children and all the adults, all the people, they make up the nations. You know, that's why they have different nations with different names. Okay? But at the same time, do you think children should spread the gospel?
Yes, sir. Jesus say he loved the children, so he want the children to tell other people about him and other children about him.
Why?
Because he loves the children.
That's right, that's right. What else he did?
He died for the children.
Okay, yes, he did die for the children. But you know, Jesus is so powerful. He said that all authority and power has been given to him. And he wants the world to know that. Sometimes we think other things is more powerful in war and different things, but there's no other power greater than the power and the authority of Jesus. Do you know that?
Yes, sir.
That's right.
That's why it's so good to know him. If you know Jesus, you know the king who got all the power.
That's right, that's right, that's right.
And the power never cut off.
No, it never cut off.
Like BP.
No, don't be sudden. Anyhow, it's very encouraging to let children know, to tell other children about the Great Commission, and to tell other children about the Lord. Okay?
Yes, sir.
That's right. Tell them who love him the most again.
Jesus loves you. Yo, yo, yo.
Thank you so much. God bless you. Hello, Charlie.
Hello.
How you feeling?
I feel good.
That's very good, Charlie. We have an interesting topic today. I was walking around the other day, and some people were saying only adults supposed to spread the gospel and talk about Jesus. You believe that?
No, sir. No, sir.
Why you don't believe that?
Because Jesus say, make disciples of all nations.
That's right. And what nations consist of?
All the people.
That's right. All the people, including the what?
The adults and the children.
That's right. The children and all the adults, all the people, they make up the nations. You know, that's why they have different nations with different names. Okay? But at the same time, do you think children should spread the gospel?
Yes, sir. Jesus say he loves the children, so he want the children to tell other people about him and other children about him.
Why?
Because he loves the children.
That's right, that's right. What else he did?
He died for the children.
Okay, yes, he did die for the children. But you know, Jesus is so powerful. He said that all authority and power has been given to him. And he wants the world to know that. Sometimes we think other things is more powerful in war and different things, but there's no other power greater than the power and the authority of Jesus. Do you know that?
Yes, sir.
That's right.
That's why it's so good to know him. If you know Jesus, you know the king who got all the power.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
And the power never cut off.
No, it never cut off.
Like BP.
No, don't be sudden. Anyhow, it's very encouraging to let children know, to tell other children about the Great Commission, and to tell other children about the Lord. Okay?
Yes, sir.
That's right. Tell them who love him the most again.
Jesus loves you. Yo, yo, yo.
Thank you so much. God bless you.
The Great Commission is often a good read. Today, we the kids are here obeying and quickly getting up to speed. And so well, going evangelizing, cause it's not a show. Making disciples and sharing a good news of Christ, you know.
We will share, others will hear, hopefully they care. Just enough to change after hearing that Jesus redeems. So let us do what we can while it is day for night is coming, and we need not to fall away.
Nobody says it like Charlie. We thank God for our yellow Bahamian. Thank you so much, Tashay and Kayan. We are grateful to God that you are a part of this ministry. Our scripture lesson will now be read by Charles Sanders. Please receive him by saying amen.
Scripture reading is Matthew chapter 28, verses 16 through 20. Then the 11 disciples went away into Galilee, into a mountain where Jesus had appointed them. And when they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, All power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, teaching them all to observe whatsoever I command you. And lo, I am with you even until the end of the world. Amen.
We will now have greetings by Pastor Ricardo Miller, all the way from Dallas, Texas. Mr. Miller is an internationally known children's pastor.
Hello, New Mount Zion Missionary Baptist Church. I am Pastor Ricardo Miller, and it is a great delight of mine to challenge you to accept the call. Yeah, you heard me correctly. I believe it's important for boys and girls to understand that your existence is necessary in this hour. You have been given birth for a reason. And when you understand that inside of you is everything you need to fulfill your purpose and to maximize your potential, you'll start showing up at church, literally through the virtual platforms or whenever we provide services in our church setting again for you. You've got to know you have a purpose. Purpose is the intent for a thing, okay? When we entered this world, we entered with something unique that was given to us that the world needs. I am here today to remind you to accept the call. You know, 24 plus years ago, growing up right there in New Providence, I accepted the call. I was a wayward boy. I was a troublesome child. I just literally did not engage myself in the most healthiest of practices. I got myself in a lot of problems. But guess what? I'm extremely grateful for a church. I'm extremely grateful for the Word of God being delivered to me at a young age. What did I call a young age? For me, it was 18, but for you, it could be even younger. I think it's important that you know that time is precious. And you ought not waste your time. As a matter of fact, you need to learn how to utilize your youthful years in giving yourself to the service of God. God has a plan for you. You've got to say that. You've got to believe that. And then you have to make a commitment every day to live that out. You're going to accept the call because accepting the call is a part of our responsibility as believers. The Bible says in Matthew chapter 28, Jesus said, listen, go ye into all the world. Okay, go ye into all the world. Maybe you may start in your house, then on your street, then in your neighborhood. Before you know it, you're doing it on the entire island, and then you may be throughout the region and ultimately the world. But the world needs Jesus more now than ever. The Bahamas needs Jesus more now than ever. Your community needs Jesus more now than ever. So our responsibility as individuals, when we understand that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believe in him shall not perish but have everlasting life, you've accepted him as your Lord and personal Savior. The next thing after doing that is accepting the call. Accepting the call to be trained and equipped to go out and to reach others for the Lord. I am challenging you today to accept the call. Remind yourself, my purpose is necessary for this hour. I have something to offer. You're not too young to declare that I have something to offer and I'm going to make a difference. I'm going to make a difference in my lifetime. Why am I going to make a difference? Because I'm going to accept the call. God bless you all. Enjoy the rest of the day and allow yourself to engage in all things that will help you to be a greater light in your community. I'm Pastor Ricardo reminding you, we are the subtotal of the choices and the decisions we make on a daily basis. Make sure you accept the call as you move forward and grow older. God bless you guys. Have a great day.
There is no shame in deciding to follow Jesus. It is actually our game. Malik Rowe will now bless our hearts with a song. Immediately after him, we will have our Bible lesson by Sister Miriam Bain. The book of Titus tells us that the elder should teach the younger. Please join one of our elders in children's ministry who will speak to us about accepting the call. She is one who has accepted the call and has decided to follow Jesus.
Decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back. No turning back. The world behind me. The cross. The world behind me, the cross before me. The world behind me, the cross before me. No turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided.
Pleasant good day to all, to our pastors, to our children directors and leaders, and also to Kian for such an awesome introduction. Let us bow our head and look to the Lord in prayer. Father, we thank you this morning for such an opportunity, for such a privilege, Father God, that we can come before you this morning. Father, I ask you, Lord God, that I may decrease as you increase. And Father, I pray today that as this message go forward, Father, that souls who do not know you as their Lord and Savior may accept you today. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Let us look at this globe. Do you see how many countries are on the great planet? Wow. To go into all the world is really a lot of work. I am sure that the missionaries must really get tired because they have a lot of work to do. So children, today in our lesson, before Jesus was ascended to heaven, he gave the disciples an important task. Yes, they were to go into all the world and spread the gospel to others. This was not just a command for the disciples, but for all of us. Sharing the good news of Jesus is not a chore, however, but a blessing. We are agents of God. And we have opportunities to serve him and to make his name known to those near and far. Jesus has given all of us an important job to spread the good news of Jesus to everyone. We are going to discuss the importance of this God-given commandment. Jesus didn't just ask the disciples to tell the world of him if they felt like it. He wants everyone to be a part of the Great Commission. Yes, you and me. Jesus reminded his disciples that he had all authority in heaven and in earth. This shows the power he had as the Son of God. If he gives a command, we should listen. Therefore, Jesus wants the disciples to go and teach others of his laws and his sacrifice. Those instructions were not just for the disciples, but for us too. Jesus promised to be with us. What a wonderful news we can carry that out when we have shared his love and his life with others. The disciples were excited to tell everyone who would listen about Jesus. Who can you tell about Jesus? You can tell your family, your friends at home, at school, your neighbors. As a matter of fact, you can tell everyone. How can you tell about him? You can share Bible verses and stories from the Bible. You can even talk about something good or a miracle that happened in your life or somebody else's life that would possibly want someone to follow Jesus. Now, kids, don't forget, the Holy Spirit helps us when we feel nervous about sharing the gospel. Kids, all of us are called to love and serve one another and to share the gospel with others all around us. This might be people far away, or it might be those close to us. There are so many ways we can communicate God's love. We can tell people about God, and we can also live as people by demonstrating genuine care for one another. Everyone, everywhere is our mission field. Continue by explaining the main idea in your own words. If you wish to be moved like Jesus, we should strive to be obedient to his command, to tell others about Christ. Telling others about Jesus doesn't have to be difficult or complicated. Boys and girls, if you wish to be more like Jesus, we should strive to be obedient to the command to tell others about Christ. Telling others about Christ doesn't have to be difficult or complicated. We can say something as simple as, "Let me tell you what Jesus did for me." Sometimes it may seem scary to tell others about Jesus. But like I told you earlier, we have the Holy Spirit with us to guide us as we speak. Our actions allow others to see Jesus in us and thus show them the gospel. If we live in a way that is pleasing to God, others will have noticed and may even ask us, "Why are we so different?" We have to understand that we as human beings have no power to make someone get saved. The Holy Spirit must be at work in the person's life. It is only our job to tell them and leave the door open for them to accept Jesus as our Savior. Today, as I close, I want to remind you that Jesus loves you and that he wants to take you with him to his Father in heaven. And remember that God has not given you the spirit of fear, but a power of love and of a sound mind. So today I encourage you to go out and spread the good news of Jesus Christ.
I am Kian Cartwright. thanks for allowing me to be your moderator today, and it is my prayer that you first of all would accept Christ as your personal Savior, and for those of us that are saved, that we would allow the Word of God come alive in our life as we take on the challenge to go into all the world to share the gospel.
Moses from the wilderness, you put a rod in his hand, you used him to lead your people over to the promised land. Lord, I'm willing to trust in you, so take my life.